Hi everyone. So, as we know, in order to succeed in Facebook ads, we need to succeed with anything. We need to have a process. We need to understand how we're doing stuff and how we're taking stuff from one place to another place and have it ongoing in order to succeed. So, what I'm going to show you now is a really, really cool process of how to do creative testing using the Madgicx platform in a very effective way that will end up being very scalable. So, the first thing we want to do is want to come over to the creatives and create new ad. So the first thing we want to do is we want to create an ad. We can name it whatever we want to name it. Go over, make sure everything's correct. Give it an ad copy, a headline, all the different things we want to make sure are connected or connected. That's step number one. Super simple, super easy to do. Once we have that, we simply want to duplicate the existing ad we have. And once we come to duplicate, we want to change the name to test number two. Now, the only thing we want to change in this test is the creative, because we currently want to do creative testing. If we would want to be doing ad copy testing, then we will change the ad copy. But currently we want to do creative. So we select another ad, whatever it may be, and we select save. Pretty simple. And we can repeat this process as many times as we want in order to have as many ads as we want. So let's say for now we want to do it 3 times. And I'll remind you, everything is exactly the same. The only thing that's different is the creative. So we go ahead and select another creative and save. Fantastic. We've done the first part. We created the creators we want to test. The second part we want to do is we want to launch them. So in order to launch them, we want to go into the ads audience launcher. From here, we want to select an ad set, usually top of funnel, that's pretty big that we know consistently works well. We want to find one that we know that works well so we can really test the creative and not the actual audience. So let's say we know this one works well for me. I'll go ahead and select next. Now here's what I would recommend to create a creative testing campaign. So you do create with campaign. You can just call it creative testing. Perfect. And you do the add the label, super important. We want it to be ADO, not CBO. And we do create campaign. Perfect. Now we're going to launch it into my creative testing campaign. And we select next. Now here, we want to go to the new ads we just created, and now we can see them coming up over here, all the same, only different is the creative. What we want to do is super simple. Come over here and we want to duplicate this asset the number of times we selected the creative. So for example, we have three creatives we want to test, so we're duplicating it 3 times. And then what we want to do is we want to select the first one, select the first ad, save changes, come to the second one, unselect the first ad, select the second ad, save changes, and repeat for the third ad. Fantastic. Now, the really cool part is because all of them are going to be the same, we can simply select all the ads that we want because we want them all to be the same. We make all the adjustments we want, the age group, the budget, the location, the lookalike percentage, and so on and so on. But it's important that all of them are exactly the same. This way, we're giving a fair trial to each and every creator. Once we finish doing this, we save changes. And we move to the last part where we can just decide what we want to do. So because all of them are the same, we can remove a bit of these naming structures just so it's a bit more organized. For example, something like this. And we do a priority name. Very nice. And then we can even add creative testing, the name. So we know all these ad sets are actually creative testing. And from here, all we do is simply launch and we have the creative testing up in the air. Now, for those of you who want to take it to the next level, I'm going to show you something really cool of how we can also automate the process of stopping the creative testing and going ahead and identifying the winners. So if we go to automations and we create a custom automation, we can go ahead and create an automation to pause an ad after it's been active for at least 4 days, spend X amount of money, and reached enough impressions, meaning that I have all the creatives a fair trial, and now I can judge them and see how they perform. Once I've done that, I can go ahead and add to the name, for example, winner, once I identify it, once it's performed well, and the metrics for me that it performed well, which was I decided was either return on ad spend or outbound CTR. Super cool way. And then, of course, we can launch it only on the creative testing campaigns. We can select it and filter by creative testing or the names that select. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, just let us know.